Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. I am your host, Christina Marie. Again, coming through with a hand. I'm missing a nail, so if you try to call me out, I see it. I know. Anyway, welcome back to my channel. Thank you guys for tuning in again. Now let's go ahead and get right into it. We don't need all that long intro business. So if you follow me on my Rosebuds page, you know that I was doing a series titled The Breakdown through IGTV. And I kind of put a halt on that for various reasons. But anyway, one of the reasons was because I wanted to come to YouTube and I wanted more time to talk about the topics that I wanted to talk about in some of the videos. You know, IGTV only gives you about 10 minutes. Sometimes I just like to rant and I talk a lot. So I was just like, you know, YouTube just may be the better choice for me. And there's just other things, more video content that I would like to put out and really start working on and producing. So this is why we are here. But through my IGTV series, I had a series titled The Breakdown. And I got that title and that name from literally me having breakdowns. And one day I was thinking about ideas and how was I going to present my video content and how was I going to present my mental health issues and like how was I going to talk about it. And it was just honestly, when I started building everything, it was weird for me to come up with like a title, like a show title, talking about my own personal mental health. I don't know if that makes sense to anybody, but it was just like, okay, I have to develop, like, I don't have to. Well, I do, because it's my purpose and this is why I'm here. But it's like, okay, I have to develop like a show or around myself and the things that I've been through. And how do I do this? And what do I title it? Like, who's going to watch and who wants to hear about this? And one day I wrote down the breakdown because that's what I was going through, is just having different mental health breakdowns and anxiety and panic attacks and all of this. So it's just like, okay, the breakdown it is. So anyway, that's where we are here now and just kind of catching you guys up. But on my, I think it was my second episode I had did, I had one titled Control. And that was based off of, one moment. You know, okay, let me cut that off before YouTube try to play me. But anyway, I was listening to Janet Jackson and I heard Control, and I was just thinking about, and I rewatched the video, and please go watch the videos, they are still there for you. I'm just going to use this channel and this platform for me to expand upon that and for me to talk about it more. And also, I'm just in a different place in my life now. I did a video then, like I said, called Control, based off of me listening to Janet, and I'm going to expand on that now, but I'm also in a different place, so that means it's a little bit different now, and I've applied that to my life. So I was like, this is actually kind of cool for me to go back and watch videos and see how I, you know, talked about my mental health and where I was at, and now how have I applied those lessons and have they really worked. Like I said in another video, my random chit chat video, I was just talking about different people. Again, I'm not a mental health expert and I'm only talking about myself, but I was just talking about, you know, I'm here to help other people. That is what I am here for, in service. That is part of my purpose, and to be an advocate for people. And this is my way of doing that. And you may hear me say something or hear a method or something that I have applied to my life, or even you just see how I'm living now and how those things have literally changed my life. I'm not where I want to be in a lot of areas. However, when you're dealing with mental health, it's just like a battle, and it's one day at a time. So applying these lessons and seeing where I'm at right now is just a blessing, and it's just, that's what's really pushing me, is just watching myself. Sometimes you just got to do that. But anyway, so in that episode Control, I was talking about just taking your shit back, ladies, and really gaining control. And this is for everyone, it's not just, you know, restricted to ladies. But now at this point in my life, when I think about taking control, what does that mean and where am I at with that? Really understanding the power of understanding the power that you can't control people. Sorry, I'm looking at my notes down here. But the power of understanding that you cannot control people or all situations in your life. I think sometimes, and I know for me personally, again, I really try to maintain control over everything. And that was up to me, just, you know, keeping a front on how I was feeling and where I was at in my life. And I was trying to control that and everything. And when you find yourself just trying to keep control of all of these things, that's what I feel like was breaking me down. It's just like, I don't have control of these things. And then you have anxiety and you start having all of these thoughts, and you go down that rabbit hole again of all of these thoughts, and this is this, and this and this, and it's just like, stop yourself. You can't control these people or that situation. What's done is done. And now, at this point, I have to stop myself in those negative thoughts, and I literally have to say out loud, like, stop, Christina, like, you're doing too much. Just calm down. It's going to be okay. And I had to come up with my own mantra or something just to say to myself to really snap, you know, snap me out of that. And what I just say to myself is that solution-based thinking? Is that going to help you overcome this or whatever it may be? For those of you who don't know, I'll just go ahead and put that out there now. I recently lost my job. Almost not quite a month ago, a couple weeks ago, I lost my job, and we'll get into that, because that is, it's a whole topic in itself. But anyway, you know, if you've been following me on my social media, I don't feel like I have really been in a deep, dark place and been putting that out there, because when that happened, we'll get into it, but I felt like it was coming anyway. Y'all can rock with me real quick on this side note, but feel me. Write me down below if you are a Black woman and you work in any kind of area, any job, any field, industry, whatever. If you've been in a position and you have spoken up about something and they didn't like that, and they got your Black ass up out of there quick and just let you know we truly don't give a fuck about you and that family shit we was talking, yeah. But anyway, you know, and so... With that being said, you could tell there's just some feelings and emotions about that. And there are going to be. I lost my job. But I feel like the old me would have lost control. And I would have taken, I know I would have had so many breakdowns. I have not cried. I have not, like, been, you know, super upset. Yes, I'm upset, but it's just more about other things. But I say that to say is that I can just feel and see the growth, even dealing with this type of situation and where I'm at right now, is that I understand that I cannot control people. You all had made up your mind already, and you've already done that. So let's move along with it. What's next? They've done what they've done. I have to process that. And please don't get me wrong. I'm not saying, especially if you lose your job, that is your livelihood. And when somebody comes in and plays with that, and yes, I'm saying plays with it, they're not taking their shit seriously, and they're putting their responsibilities or whatever it may be off on somebody else and not really handling things the way that they should have been handled, it can really put you in a deep, dark place. And it's like, wow, I've given you my time and I've been loyal here. I have literally sold this company over $1 million worth of product alone, and I didn't see any of that in this cannabis industry. So understand, I got feelings. And, you know, losing my job, like I'm saying, it can really put you in a place and really piss you off and have all of these things and go home, and it's just like you want to break down and cry and all that. And that didn't happen for me. I went up to Stanley Marketplace with my laptop. I had my backpack with me because I already knew it was going to happen. I had my shit with me. Went up there, started applying for jobs, just started getting on all my stuff. It's like, I don't have time, I guess, anymore. And that's where I'm at right now in my life. I don't have time for that. And understanding that I can't control these people or any, like, a lot of situations, it really has helped me. I don't know how else to say that. Sorry, I just kind of went off on a tangent because I'm thinking about all these things and I'm like, wow, I know I've been in this situation before, and the old me just went down a really deep, dark hole. And it's just like, for me to not take it there, I feel so blessed and just great. Like, I don't have a job, but I am good right now. I'm happy that I'm not there, and I'm just putting all of my trust into God and doing what I can. That's all you can do, really. Control yourself and figure out what are the actions, solution-based thinking. You know, what's going to help you? And I was trying to say, please, you know, if you are upset and if you feel like you got to cry or whatever, get that shit out, because that's what happens with our mental health issues, that we keep holding things in and suppressing everything. So please let it out if you need to. I'm just saying, for me personally, where I'm at, I'm not there anymore. And so just applying these lessons, I feel like, is what's gotten me here. And I'm so thankful that I have, and really working on self and self-love and self-care. That's really what this is for me. But you know, you can lose control and gain control of your life. And this is where I'm at. It's like, I'm gaining control. I may be here. People have made a decision that they made a long time ago that they wanted to get my black ass up out of there. And that's fine. And I'm not going to lose control over that. I'm going to gain control. All you did was lift me up. So thank you so much. I am thankful. I thank you for the time, for my checks. Didn't see none of that million, but it's okay. And then I keep it pushing and move on to the next. That's all you can do. You know, and then my video, I was talking about anxiety attacks. There was another video I watched of mine too. I was watching my own videos like, well, shit. But anxiety attacks, you know, when you're having one, again, in my last video, I was saying it's hard to explain it, but you start to just, for me, sometimes I'll just sit there and stare and zone out, and I go down this whole path. It's just literally me staring, not blinking, and it's scary sometimes to be in that place and have those feelings. Like, I never thought that I would be here having these type of anxiety attacks, but I lose control of my thoughts and all of these things, and it's just like, I don't want to go there again. And I'm trying to do everything within my power to make sure that I apply the lessons, and I don't. But I just can't stress enough how important it is to take control of your life and everything around it and your mind. Take control of your boundaries. Set your boundaries for your friends or your spouse or family members. We like to make excuses for certain family members, like, oh, that's my mom, that's my daddy, that's my uncle, that's my brother. Toxic is toxic is toxic is toxic. Some of them motherfuckers got to get cut out or go, or you have to limit your time to them. You can unfollow or mute them on social media. You don't have to. I know social media is such a big thing, and it's like, well, I don't want them to feel a certain kind of way if I unfollow them. Fuck them. Fuck them. If some people are negative, fuck what they think. This is where I'm at. I just don't care what you feel, how my decisions on getting myself to a better place, how it makes you feel. I'm going to make sure that I do my best to not offend or go out of my way to be nasty or crazy to anyone. But at the same time, if I need to cut you out because you are the toxic person, the toxic job that I've been loyal to, the toxic manager, the toxic spouse, parent that I've been taking care of, or what have you, you have to go. Literally, you are literally killing me slowly because I'm stressing out so much, and my mental health and my body and my personal health is like being taken over by your shit because you keep projecting and put it on me. I'm taking control and let you know, listen, we can kick it, but these will be the days that I will be available. Why? I don't have to explain too much to you. I really don't need to explain anything. Take it or leave it. I just am so, y'all can tell I'm passionate. Shout out to Amanda Seals. It's like, you know, I'm not hostile, I'm not any of these other things. I'm just very passionate about it because I am seeing and feeling the effects of setting boundaries. I've been so loyal to a fault to jobs because I have settled and I haven't felt like I should ask for more or reach for more. So they offer this and this is what I'm taking because that's okay. I'll just, oh, all right, thank you so much. You know, it's like, take control. But anyway. Sorry, I just went down this whole tangent, but I'm a huge, the heck is happening here, advocate of this part of your life because I just feel like it can really help a lot of us out in this time and in this climate. People will take advantage of you, and sometimes they don't even notice that they're doing it. They can just always count on you, and it's just like, nope, not happening. So take control of your boundaries, take control of your notifications on who you follow on your social media, even your explore page. My explore page on my business page, I intentionally follow a shit ton of decor and plant accounts, okay, house plants. And when I go to my explore page, oh, and food, I hella like macaroon cakes. I don't know, it's weird and random, but, and dogs and like animals. But these are the things that I see when I go to my explore page, and that's intentional. And it's nothing, it's almost like a mood or vision board for me. So when I click on my explore page, that's all I see. I see the types of home and decor that I want for my home, and it's so peaceful and so calming. And who would have thought social media would be that? But it's how you set it, and I'm controlling that. And so I encourage you to do that. Change all of that, and you know, change your perspective and see how your life will change. But you know, with people, again, if they're offended or feeling some kind of way about things, coworkers who overstep their goddamn boundaries, you know what? You just gonna have to stay your ass over there. Namaste your ass over there. I said that in my last video. People just have to learn, and it's hard for people because they feel like, again, they want control over you, or y'all been tired, or we cousins, or woozy woo, and this how you gonna act. And it's like, okay, so now I'm starting to see maybe we're growing apart, and maybe it's time to call this relationship a day, because you over there and I'm over here, and this is all we gonna keep doing. I don't have time for that. You know what I'm saying? The only time I'm trying to do this is not get you butt. Happy anniversary to not get you butt. That's today. But anyway, check that. But anyway, take control of your finances, your notifications, who you follow on social media, your family members, your coworkers, your mental state, and when you start to go down that rabbit hole of having anxiety attacks. I don't want us sitting around having those moments where we feel like we can't pick ourselves up. And it's hard. It is so hard. I know it is so hard. You look at the political climate, just daily news, people in general. When I was working at the store, I'm like, damn, here I am in a dispensary and I've been working retail forever. I'm gonna be 35 this year, okay? And I've worked a shit ton of jobs. And it saddens me that I have to admit, but I've dealt with some of the worst customers working in the dispensary. And it was a lot of tourists who just don't understand the laws or rules, or I was challenged a lot by a lot of white men who would come in. I was the only black girl at the time working in there. Black person working in my store, and they come in and it's like, I see you being nice to the front desk girl, I see you being nice to this person, but the moment you find out that I'm your bartender and I'm telling you that these are the laws, or you can't have your phone out, you can't look at the medical stuff, you want to challenge me. And it's like, I don't know if it's because I'm telling you no, or because you are offended by my big ass hair, or you don't like my black ass skin, but this is what it is. And it's just like, it was so frustrating, and it's like, what is the deal? So maybe we have to talk about that as well and start giving some information for tourists. So it's like, make the experience much easier for your butts. Like, I sell weed all day. That's what I did. So why are we like having such an attitude? I'm here to sell you an ounce at 8. Like, I love my job. I love selling weed. Like, that was just a few of my experiences. I'm not saying that it was all terrible. I'm not saying all tourists, because I know people will hear that and be like, blah, blah, blah. No, there were just some that were just simply trash and super terrible to me, and like would come at me, and it's like, I'm not the one, and I'm the one to keep the same energy. You serving up some bullshit, and it's like, I'm gonna try and keep it cool and calm and collected. The moment you start disrespecting me or dismissing me or trying to be funny about some shit, it's like, all right, here we go. But anyway, that's another story for another day. So let me know what you guys think. I know I was, just feeling it, but this is me and this is who I am, and this is just how I feel about these things. I just know how important it is to take control of your life, and this is where I want us to be collectively. Again, life is hard. There are things going on there. I'm still going through things. I just lost my job. I'm still losing weight, and I just lost my health insurance a couple days ago. I'm like a little nervous to not have health insurance considering where my personal health is at right now. So all I can do is try and focus on the things that I can control and keep pushing forward and hope that I find an amazing job, or I end up working for myself, or whatever it may be. But gotta keep pushing forward. So let me know in the comments below, whatever you gotta say, whatever, let me know. Follow me on Instagram, rosebuds_high. I was like, where am I going with that? And till next time, I love you guys. I don't even know how I was going to end that video. Don't know. A word to Lawrence and Larimer. If you follow me on Instagram, you know that I co-hosted their Betty Rose fashion show. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I love this piece. I love tanks. I got to have my pits out in the summertime because it's too hot for that shit. So, yeah. But anyway, I love you guys. Till next time, much love, peace, and blessings.